Do you know that what is wall and why we use the wall in the industry? What are the different applications of the wall in the industry? If yes, then good. If no, so in this video, we are going to discuss about the what is wall, application of wall in the industry, parts of the wall. We will discuss about the each part of the wall. Then we will discuss about the which factors influence the wall design. Then classification of the wall, and we can also say the types of the wall. Then in the last, we will discuss about the naming of the wall. Okay, so this is the first video on the wall. Here we are going to discuss about the introduction of the wall. So there will be sequence of the videos, and we will make the separate playlist of the wall where we will discuss about the each wall which is used in the industry, like gate wall, globe wall, angle wall, butterfly wall, ball wall, plug wall, needle wall. We will discuss about the each wall, their application, their advantage, their disadvantage. Okay, so hello everyone, welcome in LearnCHE. If you are new in this channel, you can subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that you could get the latest notification. Okay, so let's start the video from the what is wall. Here first we discuss about the definition of the wall. What is the meaning of wall, right? So that is very important. First you should know about the definition. So wall is a mechanical device. Okay, we may say like it is a fitting. Okay, what is the fitting? Like elbow, which we use in our piping system, right? T, which we used in our piping system. Okay, so you can say wall is a mechanical device or fitting in a pipeline. Okay, it means that it will use in a pipeline. Okay, which is used in an industry. Okay, to control, to give the direction, to regulate, to hold, etc. the following fluid in a pipeline by opening or closing or by partially action. Means partially open or partially close. What is this means? It means that suppose there is my wall, and I am, suppose this is my pipeline, okay? And in this pipeline, from here, my fluid is flowing. From here, my fluid is flowing. Now, if I have to send this fluid from here to here, okay, from here to here, so what I can do, I will have to open this wall, okay? Now, I see the students or newcomers, when they come into the industry, so they do not know that how to open, like by which this wall will be open and by which this wall will be closed. So there is one thumb rule, that is like the wall will be open at the anti-clockwise, okay, and the wall will be closed by the clockwise. So if I have to open this wall, what I'll do, I'll apply the anti-action, right? I'll rotate this in the anti-clockwise action, or like I'll give the anti-clockwise movement, so it will be open. As it will open, my fluid will start flowing from here to this side. Got it my point? Now if I want to control the flow, I can do. And suppose if there is any other wall, right, angle wall suppose, so I can also give the direction. I can control, means I can control its flow, means I can regulate the flow, and I can also hold. Suppose I have to isolate this side, so what I can do, I can just simply close this wall, so my fluid will not go from here to here, right? It will be isolate this side. I can simply say that it will hold my flowing fluid, or it will isolate my flowing fluid. Okay, so this is the simple meaning of the wall, and here this is a control wall. Okay, this one is a control wall. So in the control wall, you can simply give the signal, and by giving the signal, it will simply open. Like it may open 25%, 20%, 50%, 75%, by which you can regulate the flow, or you can simply close it so that you could hold, or you can isolate the system or your vessel or your pipeline. Got it my point? What I want to say, mainly simply the wall is a mechanical device or a fitting which we used in a pipeline to give the direction, to control the flow, to regulate the flow, okay, by opening, by closing the wall. Okay, simply how you will regulate the flow, by opening or by closing. Okay, that is a very simple definition which you should know. Okay, Now, what are the applications of the wall? Okay, applications of the wall in the industry. So, the first application which you will see of the wall in the industry is that on or off. Means, suppose this line is connected. Okay, whether you want to on it means your fluid will flow like this. If suppose it is a on, or suppose if you want to off it. So, what will happen that your fluid will not flow like this. So, here your fluid will be not go. Got it my point? So this means that you can simply use it in a pipeline as a on off purpose, on or off purpose. Okay, and what are the others? To change the direction. Okay, you can also provide your fluid, flowing fluid to the direction. Okay, you can provide the direction to your flowing fluid. Okay, so it may be used to change the direction. Okay, if you want to, suppose if you want to change the direction of your fluid, so it you may use the wall. And relieving overpressure or release excess pressure. Suppose if there is your one system, this is your vessel, and this vessel is a pressurized vessel. So what you can do, you can use here one pressure safety wall. Okay, you can use here one pressure safety wall. So what will happen that whenever this vessel will be pressurized, it will actuate or it will be pop up. Suppose this is my pressure safety wall. So like we may use this pressure safety wall to release the excess pressure. Okay, and control the flow direction, or you can say that prevent the reverse flow, we use the check wall, or also known as the non-return wall. This is my check wall. What happens here that if this check wall will be designed at a particular pressure, okay, so if that pressure will be there at the inlet, this check wall or this NRV will be open, otherwise it will be closed. So what will be happen here, there cannot be reverse flow, or this check wall is only used to give the one direction. Okay, so that's why I have written here the control the flow direction. It is also used to vent. Suppose if you want to vent your gases, you want to vent the cooling water, whatever you want to vent, it can also use their flow regulation. I have already told you it is also used as to air fail to open or air fail to close. We will discuss about these walls in our later videos. I hope you got the point that where these walls applications are and where we may use the walls. Okay, there are also other applications as well. If you know, let me in the comments box the more examples or more application of the walls. Now here you can see the parts of the wall. Okay, now we will discuss about the parts of the wall. Okay, this is my ball wall. Here you can see that. Okay, this is a systematic engineering diagram of the ball wall, where you can see that the first one is a body. Okay, this part is my body, and here in this picture, this is my body. Okay, this is the handle. Okay, this one is a steam. You can also correlate from here. This one is a steam. This is handle. This cover means upper body and the down body, and this is the body. Okay, this is the body, is connected by the nut and bolts. Okay, now in this wall, this is not a ball wall. Okay, this is not ball wall, but these all system or these all components will be there as well. Okay, in this third one there is a ball disc. Okay, so this is my ball disc. Okay, by the opening of this ball disc, my fluid will be flow. Okay, if this ball disc is completely seated or placed in the seat, that is second one, this one is my seat. Okay, if it is completely placed in this seat, it means that my wall is closed. Same will be happen with the gate wall, globe wall, plug wall. Okay, if it will go away from this seat, it means that my wall is opening. Okay, suppose this is my seat. Okay, something like that, and this is my disc and this is the steam, let's suppose it. Okay, now if it will go far away from my seat, so what will happen that this wall will be open. If it will come closer to this seat, it means that my wall will be closed. Got it my point? I have already told you about the nuts, cover and body, O-ring. Now, why we use the packing? The packing is mainly used to restrict the fluid to leakage. Okay, it prevents from the leakage. Okay, that's why we use the packing. You will not find packing in the ball wall mainly, but in the gate wall, glove wall, in control walls, you will find the packing. Okay, there are the screw. Okay, steam, that is the fifth one. So 15, that is the steam, and in our case, this one is a steam. Okay, so these are the parts of the wall. Now you can see that this is my ball wall and this is not the ball wall. Now let me in the comments box which type of wall is this, if you know that. Okay, whether it is a gate wall or whether it is a globe wall, and which type of wall is this, let me in the comments box if you know. Okay, I hope you got the point that which parts of the body has which work. Okay, like what is the body, what is the meaning of seat. Mainly the seat and disc is important, that is very very important. This is the handle. Okay, this is the handle, so which will give the, you can say, which will provide the action, whether you have to close or you have to open it, whether you have to close it partially or open it partially. Okay, so this is the part, this is all about the parts of the wall. If you have any doubt, let me in the comments box. I'll clear your doubt whenever I'll see your comments. Okay, now what are the wall design factors? Okay, so while sizing the wall or while designing the walls, which factors we include? Mainly we include that types of fluid to be handled. Okay, which type of fluid we are going to handle, that is very important criteria or important factor which we used or which we consider while designing the wall. Line sizing means while designing the line, okay, while designing the pipeline, we do the line sizing. In the line sizing, mainly you will do the velocity, you will follow the velocity criteria or pressure criteria. Okay, that is also very very important. Okay, because you should know that, like, what is the velocity and what is the pressure your wall and your pipeline could be withstand. Got it my point? And in the third point, pressure and temperature condition. What are the pressure and temperature conditions are there? And fluid properties, whether this fluid is viscous or not, corrosive or not. So you will also consider this one as well. And in the final, that is very very important, that is the pressure drop across the wall. Suppose if you are using any particular wall and in that wall pressure drop is more, okay, and across the wall the pressure drop is high, so, and you do not want the pressure drop high, so you want the accuracy there. Okay, you want the accuracy, so you will not use that wall, you will use any other wall. Okay, so this all parameters comes under the designing factors. Okay, these factors influence the wall designing, that is very very important, which you should know. Okay, now the classification of the wall. Okay, mainly the walls are classified in the two groups. The first one is rotary walls and the second one is linear motion walls. Okay, some books you will also find that the walls are classified as the steam, by the steam movement. Okay, by the steam movement. Okay, what is it means? It means simply that by the steam movement, the first types of the walls will be rotary walls and the second one will be sliding type. Okay, the meaning is same, you do not have to worry. Okay, in the rotary walls, what is the meaning of rotary? Means you are providing the one quarter, means you are turning your wall. Suppose this is my ball wall. Okay, what you will do while you, suppose if you have to close this wall, what you will do, you will turn this wall. Okay, you will provide the quarter turn, or you can also say that you will be turn it in a 90 degree. Okay, not always you will do it 90 degree. Suppose if you have to open it 50%, so you will turn it into the 50% or in the 45 degree, right? So in the rotary wall, you provide the quarterly turn. Got it my point? Here are the examples, are ball wall, plug wall, butterfly wall, etc. Okay, in the linear motion wall, what you do, there will be here you can see that this is the linear motion walls. Okay, you will open it by giving the anti-clockwise motion. While giving the anti-clockwise motion, after that this wall will be open. Okay, that's why we say that this is a linear motion walls. Okay, like examples are globe wall, that was the globe wall, gate wall, needle wall, angle wall, etc. Give me the more examples of the rotary walls. If you know that, let me in the comments box. Okay, here you can see that this is my plug wall, and here what you will do, you will simply turn it. Okay, whether you have to open or close it, you will simply turn it, and by giving your action, it will be close or open. Okay, so that's why it is a rotary type motion, rotary types wall. And in case of the linear motion, you will have to provide the motion, whether it may be anti-clockwise or it may be clockwise. Got it my point? Now in the last, naming of the wall. Okay, you have to give the name of the wall. Okay, so that you could know that which type of walls is this. Okay, so by the shape of the disc. Okay, like I have told you, suppose this is my disc. Okay, it is an integral internal part of the wall, and this is my seat. Okay, so the naming of the wall depends upon the shape of the disc, like gate wall, ball wall, plug wall. These are the, by the shape of the disc, by the this disc shape, you can decide whether it is a gate wall. Ball wall means this disc will be like a ball. Okay, same in the plug wall, we will discuss about it. Now shape of the body means this one. Okay, which type of the body, and by the shape of the body, you can predict that which type of the wall will it be, like the globe wall. Okay, safety wall, like PSV, PRV. This one is a PSV, which we use as a safety wall. Now by the function, okay, by the function you can say like control wall, CV. This is my control wall. Okay, so depending upon the shape of the disc, depending upon the shape of the body, safety purpose, by the function, okay, the name of the walls are decided or given. Okay, so these are the main, like these are the some basic information which you must know about the wall, whether this wall is a pressure safety wall or whether this is a control wall. And why this is a control wall? Because we have given the name on the basis of function. Why this is a pressure safety wall? Because this wall is using in the industry because of the safety purpose. That's why it is a safety wall. Why this is a globe wall? Because its body is like a globe. Okay, so you must know about it. So in this video, we discussed about the introduction of the walls. If you like this video, you can simply like the video, you can share this video to your friends in your groups, and if you are new in our YouTube channel, you can subscribe our YouTube channel.